highly learned faculty in the form of Dr. Mustafa Saasa from Dubai. And he has done doctorate in leadership from Colombo University. He is chairman and managing director of Raj Group of Companies and has several other business portfolios with him. Dr. Mustafa has received recognition worldwide. But for us, I would say, he was invited to President's House when several innovators were invited. We are very fortunate that Dr. Mustafa, he is here in a very short span of time. Only a few months back, we had a wonderful session from him on Blue Ocean Strategy, which is being utilized by many organizations to carve out niche areas for their products or services. Dr. Mustafa has been awarded Mahatma Gandhi Pravasi Sanman in the House of Lords, London. He has also been conferred with Bharat Sanman Award in New Delhi and India's Most Influential Leader in Dubai, UAE. With this small background, I would request Dr. Mustafa to take over for today's session on business mindset and business legacy. On behalf of AMA, I would like to honor him with flower of bouquet.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am highly grateful to Mr. Prashant Gandhi and AMA to give me opportunity to present this topic on business mindset and business legacy. Among the audience, I can see a lot of champions of the industry sitting here and the connoisseurs in their own business. So in fact, you know, I'll try to keep it a little bit more interactive as well. So, you know, we can have an exchange on their views on the business legacy and business mindset. Business mindset is not only limited to businessmen. Business mindset is a phenomenon wherein every person can apply this for their own growth. It's not only necessary that a businessman should have a business mindset. Now in the corporates, there are internal clients. Also, there is a segment which is called internal clients. And they are the sales force who interacts with the clients outside. So for them, their behavior, their thinking, and their logic is exactly the same as of a businessman. Any salesperson with an incentive attached to his performance, he should have and he is having a business mindset to convert his performance into a good achievement and be a good performer in the company as well. But there are certain fundamentals to have this business mindset, certain principles. And as I see that most of the audience are from Gujarat, and some of them, you know, our dear friend has come all the way from Udaipur to attend this, Mr. Rajesh. So from the nearby, we know as a Gujarati, we know that business mindset is so important in the business, because I have personally seen, as I've traveled 80 countries in the world, wherever I see any Gujarati company in any part of the world, I see them the champion of the industry. I was very overwhelmed to see when I went to Uruguay in South America. The capital is Montevideo, and one of the largest organizations was TCS, owned by Tata, and Tatas are predominantly Gujaratis. And you know, it was publicly told in the forum in Vibrant Gujarat as well by Mr. Ratan Tata. So you know, we are are a business community, but having this business mindset, all the person, any person, can excel and flare in their organization. This is the first topic of the two, you know, which we are going to discuss today. There is a very fine difference between dignity and pride. Abhiman ane garva vachenu bahu j nanu antar hoy che. It's a very thin line. So a businessman with a business or a business mindset person should always take care of having himself in this arena of dignity, and should never ever go into the arena of pride, because as everyone knows and very well said in English, that pride comes before any fall. So it's a very fine line, and I have experienced that many a times that the sales team in the company, they have that kind of that attitude that, you know, we are the profit centers in the company, and we feed the rest of the company. That's very nice, of course, and it's their job. In fact, in our company, I tell our salespeople that you are the head of the family. In any society and culture, the head of the family is responsible for providing livelihood and bringing livelihood and feeding the family. But in that sense of pride should never come in, because if the back office will not support them, they will not achieve what they are achieving in their sales. And some of the principles what we apply in our company, I will share with you. If we are governing any meeting, and whoever is chairing the meeting has two things to say first. If I chair the meeting in with my employees or with my board or my management, the first thing I will stand up and say that I confess publicly that I make the most mistakes among everyone sitting in the room. And the second thing I say, that with whose fortune this company is running, I don't know, but at least I know that my fortune is not running in this business. The two logics behind this is that if a person chairing the meeting or the head of the organization confesses and that, you know, I make the mistakes, the subordinates will never have any nanum of accepting their mistakes. Because normally what happens, not accepting the small mistakes, it snowballs into a bigger one, and by the time you identify, you know, it becomes too complicated. So we have that attitude that, see, we all are human beings. Manas bhulne patra che, human is bound to make mistakes, is not maybe, is bound to make mistakes. So this culture we have formed, that mistakes are going to happen by anyone, but if you accept it in the early stage, that will not result into a snowball effect. The second thing what I say is that, you know, regarding the fortune, that ama kono naseeb chale je khabar nahi, but maru nahi chaltu. I publicly say this. The reason is that, you know, that sense of pride never comes into any subordinate. That company is running on me or marathi company chale che. So that thing is very important. So thus, you know, in this, these are the two fine lines which a person has to think upon. The very important thing in this is to identify your talent. Every person is blessed with some extraordinary talent. And Galileo has said in 16th century that I have yet to meet a person who is so ignorant that I can't learn anything from him. On 9th of July last month, I was invited in Jaipur in one program which was Interfaith Harmony, and coincidentally that day was a Guru Purnima. We pay respect to our Guru, and on the dais all the champions of the industry and all the big Gurus were sitting there. And in that, you know, I said that I know that you all are the big champions of your own industry, but I know one thing, that I am a shishya, I am not a guru. That is the first thing. Second, this talent, and I was again, you know, I was asked that whom do you feel as your role model, or whom do you think as your teacher? I said, I have got 5,000 teachers. A person walking on the road teaches me something. My subordinate teaches me something. My peon teaches me something. My office boy teaches me something. So I have something to learn from everyone. So thus, everyone is blessed with a talent. Now, many a time what happens is that, of course, we have acquired and inherited certain talents, but a person is working in complete different direction. If you identify your talent, even by getting counseled by some experts, and then you work into that area, you will flare much better than what you are doing now. Maybe you are doing, what you are doing now is good, but by doing that, you will flare in that. So this is one of the very important thing, identifying your talent. The second after this is, once you have identified your talent, then it's very important to nurture the talent. You have to nurture your hidden talent. Some are in the early age we can know that this boy or a child is good in drawing. Then the parents has to give some extra efforts to put him into that line, rather than forcing them to do something what is the wish of the parents. Sports, many are now internationally, sports is taken as a profession. Many of the students I have seen have taken sports as a profession. So it's not only that sports is a leisure activity, it's a profession. And we have seen, you know, how the good cricketers, because in India cricket is a religion and everybody knows, and how well the cricketers are getting their yield on their expertise rather than putting in any other field. Now, after nurturing your talent, always try to induce creativity in whatever you do. This is a very important aspect of a mindset, of a business mindset. See, many of the connoisseurs and the champions of the industry are sitting here. I'll ask you one question. 30, 40 years back, the business, the way business was done, is it done the same way now?
No.
The rules of the game have completely changed. May it be the same business, but the rules of the game have changed. So always try to induce creativity in your business. So that's a very important mindset, having creativity induced in whatever you do as a person, as a company. Most of the corporates, rather in the UAE, all the corporates are not as a mandatory, but it has become a culture to have a creative club in them, or innovation cell in the company. And they are responsible for thinking on how we can improve on customer service, how we can improve on the product, what is the next generation of product can be bought into this. It's a thought. Maybe they are not the developers. The development will be done by someone else, or by scientists, or by engineer, but giving a thought to it, what next? So inducing creativity is a very important aspect on a business mindset and business growth. Always learn to be different. The thing is that, see, you know, many of the champions have emerged out of the common players. Like if I tell you, the textile business was been done in the same way, almost plus minus little bit here and there, and there emerged a giant industry started by Dhirubhai Ambani in textile. So like that, you know, he did things differently. He didn't do anything different. He did things differently. same as if you say of Infosys or any other giants right now. So you know they were among one of the same players in the initial stage, but doing something different and becoming an creating an identity. Now doing something different has always a need behind it. Like when you do something different, always you have to ask a question: why are you doing this? What benefit it will give to the humanity? iPhone, Apple is a known story. Steve Jobs, whenever he used to design something, he used to ask, why am I doing this? He used to ask, what am I doing and how will I do it? Okay, that's a requirement. But he always used to ask question, why am I doing it? And now, majority of the world is touched with Apple products. So this why has to be asked, and doing that into that direction will create something different. Of course, right now we are not talking about right or wrong. We are not talking about anything else, but doing something differently, a company can emerge out of the same lot and creates its own identity. Now in this process of doing something different, inducing creativity, one very important element one has to think and one has to adhere to is to never lose the right way. That's a very, very important thing. Many a time a thing starts with a good intention, but at some point you lose the focus, and for some recognition, increment or something, you compromise on many ethical things. So never lose the right way. One of the statement by our Honorable Prime Minister he says that, you know, shortcut will cut you short. So this is no to shortcut. So never lose the right way and adhere to it. Next. In this process, as I told, induce creativity, never losing the right way, always we have to think beyond. Like many of you must be knowing how you connect the 9 dots with the 4 lines. So if you try it within this frame of 9 points, you can never do it. But by extending up on one side and extending down on the other side with 4 lines, you can connect these 4 dots. So always you have to think beyond. When I say think beyond in the business mindset is not only thinking to that particular deal or particular time period where you can take benefit from it. Many a times you are not earning enough in this deal, or you are maybe losing, but thinking beyond as a company or making a client is very important in the long run. Maybe a client, if he is satisfied and the client is of that magnitude, that feather in the cap can get you other business. So thinking beyond is very important, not limited to your product or the deal at that time. Of course, we are so blessed to live in the very high cultured country. If I put Indian culture on one side and the entire world culture on the other side, our Indian culture is much richer than any other culture in the world. And one of the belief what we have is that, you know, blessings of parents. That is a very important thing in a business mindset. See, many a time we do something and we get a returns on it. It is not result of our efforts or our doings. It is so many people who has helped us. And I normally practice this. Any of the accolades or any recognition if I get, I have 2 opening statements. First statement, I say that, you know, I am proxy to the real awardees. The real awardees are all those who have helped me to reach here. If I look back And if I see that even one person wouldn't have helped me at that particular time, I wouldn't be into this position now. So parents are our first God. That Almighty God, where we are going to reach? That Prabhu is so high. The parents are our first God, and their blessings are very important in the business, in all the doings what we have. So, and we are blessed with this culture. So I congratulate each one of you sitting here that, you know, we all are blessed with this culture, but we need to improve if we are undermining this. And of course, the blessings, the power of blessings, at any point of time in your life, everyone must have experienced this power of blessings. The power of blessing is such that can, it is said that faith can move mountains, and it can really move mountains. I don't know, you know, in very recent movie which I saw of Salman Khan, and that was disliked by many. Can somebody remind me the name of the movie?
Tube Light.
Very right. When I saw this movie, I got a wonderful message from this, and the message in this movie was on faith. Entertainment was okay, plus minus, it is subjective, but what I got a message from this movie is a tremendous faith, and that faith moves this. That's why, you know, in that movie it is really shown that mountain shaking, you know. Of course that's picturized, but that message is so clear. So that's the power of blessings what we have. As I told earlier, you know, no to shortcuts. Shortcut may, in any business mindset, you know, shortcut will, you will have an immediate benefit, but if you see in the long run, you are the loser. I can give you examples of many companies who accelerated at a very high pace, but then, you know, with the shortcuts, they fall and they disappear, or they are absconding. And one of the example is Kingfisher. So, you know, this shortcut will cut you short. So in business mindset, always you have to think for the long perspective and the long thing, rather than getting anything done short Now we are living in a very volatile world. We have challenges on daily basis, challenges on hourly basis. So we have to prepare for challenges. I know in the previous, thank you, sir. In the previous time when the sailing was smooth, the companies used to make 5 years plan, 3 years plan. Even Indian government used to make 5-year yojana. That 5 years plan, planning commission was there. Now in this volatile world, some of the companies, you work on quarters. Most of the MNCs, they work on quarters. On quarterly basis you plan, and quarterly performance are seen and evaluated. So in this volatile world, you have to prepare yourself for the challenges. So business mindset, always try to keep some buffer. It's not that, you know, what we have is ready to use. So we have to prepare for challenges. Challenges may be in the mindset of the clients, in market behavior, in the changes in the legislation. Recently we saw a major change in the Indian law in taxation, and the entire country is dancing. So, you know, to make themselves in order to adhere to the requirement of the government. So, and I saw that some of the biggest agitations which were done in some of the cities, they all were non-taxpayers. So they drive a car of 2 crore, live in the house of 10 crore, and their business is only 50 lakhs. So of course, you know, so they were not prepared for this challenge. So when government came out with this law, and they suddenly found themselves that they are either out of business or they cannot cope up. So always think of challenges and prepare for it. Now, once you know the challenge coming in, you have to overcome the challenge. If I see the sail coming, a surfer will take it as an opportunity. Wow, what a tide, I should surf on it. And the one who doesn't know swimming will have a fear of drowning himself. So always preparing for challenges and try to overcome for the challenges. Especially in the sales team, every client is a new client. So in the business also, you know, we have especially if somebody is in the retail, we have every client has a different mindset. Every client has a different aspiration from this product. So always try to overcome and prepare for his answers, prepare for what he is looking for. If a series of clients asking the same question, then note it down and may these changes can happen. This is how creativity and induced creativity starts. Necessity is the mother of invention. So when somebody asks us the same thing, try to innovate or try to bring something for their requirement. In fact, when Apple, and especially Steve Jobs, when he introduced tablet, there was no precedence for that product in the market. And all his advisors told him that, sir, there is no market for this. Either we have cell phones or smartphones and we have computers. He said that people don't know what they want. I know what they want. And right now, tablet is one of the most selling device in the world. So this is, always try to create something new. Again, you know, this is a very important slide and a very important note that be confident, not overconfident. It is again a very thin line between confidence and overconfidence. To walk on a tight rope on Niagara Fall is a talent, but not to do is an intelligence. So this is something, you know, and a lot of people have lost their lives doing that. Okay, few must have crossed it. It's fine, you know, this thing is very important in any business mindset. And in business mindset, there is a vendor and a client. Now, client is always smarter than the vendor. This is a mindset we have always to keep. Gandhiji has written a book on customer. And in that, he has written that customer is God. And in many ways, that can be proved. Because as we think that our risk is coming from the customer, our fortune and our livelihood is coming from the customer. So in one way, he is. And in fact, in the Arabian world, for the boss, you know, one particular word is used as arbab. They use that for the boss, they use arbab. Arbab word has come from rab. And in one way, he is getting his fortune from him. So that way he is his rab. But of course, not that almighty. Like parents are our first God, but they are not almighty. So in that way, the customer can be termed as a God. So in this mindset, always a person has to be confident, but he has to always make sure never to be overconfident. And this normally, you know, I've seen some salesmen, they say, our client tumhara gajwa ma chhe, is in my pocket. There is no clients in anybody's pocket. We have seen market turnaround in no time. Everybody were having 5 years back Nokia in their pocket. And now if I can ask how many Nokias in the room, it will be difficult, you know, this thing. So, of course, same as a BlackBerry. So this thing, the market sentiments and market trends can change anytime. Of course, you know, as parents are important and their blessing are important, the faith in God, as I discussed earlier in this movie also, it has been lauded very clearly, that faith in God is very important thing. You always have to think eventually that whatever I receive and I get is from that Almighty. Now, this is a very debatable thing and we will not go into that, but I'll just give you a small synopsis of that. That there is one school of thought which says that whatever I do, if it is in knowledge of Almighty or it was programmed the way I am going to do, then if I do good or bad is all by wish of God. The one school of thought says that no, what karma e apna hath ma cha, it is in our hand. Now there is one very some research which I did and some observation which I found, I'll just share with you in a very nutshell. Almighty has given us all the liberty to choose. Humans are the only living thing in the world who God has given intelligence to rationalize things. Among all the living things, may it be plants and animals and everything. So, Almighty God has given us this freedom to choose. Now, in this freedom to choose, what we are going to choose with our intelligence, that Almighty God is knowing. It's not that He has programmed us. He has given us all the freedom to choose, and in this freedom, what we are eventually going to choose, that Almighty God is knowing in advance. So someone cannot say that, okay, my failure is because mara to bhagya ma ja chhe. Sorry, I cannot correct my yesterday and the past hour, but surely I can improve my future by lot of factors involved in that, and one of them is having a correct mindset. I did my master's in emotional intelligence and my dissertation was on mindset correction. In this process, you know, I have interviewed some hardcore criminals, means they have 2, 3, 4 murders plus and they don't have any sign of repenting. So when I interviewed them and when I talked to them for half an hour, 45 minutes, I made them cry. A person only cries when he feels he has done something wrong. That zameer and that that repenting was gone. So we alive him. And then I asked him that if you are again put to that situation, will you commit this crime? He said, no sir, I will not do it. So this faith in God is a very important thing. And as you know, this was a little away from the topic what I discussed, a little bit of spiritual and little bit of emotional thing. But of course, we all in India, of course, our culture, as our rich culture says, that we all are a believer of faith. And in this, you know, faith in God is a very important thing, will help you to grow. People ask me many a times, Sahib, what is the secret of your success? I tell them one more thing, that it is some blessings working, not me, first. And second, I say them, it is very simple to be successful. The more you become successful, induce more humanity into you. Jitla tame agar vadho, etli namanta hi vadharo tamara ma. Jo e vadharso e bahu saral seedhi chhe. It is very simple thing, one can do it. And that starts from your family, from your subordinates, from everyone. A smile can take you miles. So, you know, this is a very important thing. The next, you know, of course, prayers pay. It's not the only element, but it acts as a booster. In our house or some places where, you know, it's a big house and there is a Wi-Fi installed in one corner, and to get the Wi-Fi on the other end, you put a booster in between. So prayer acts as a booster. Any religion, any caste, anything what you believe in, if you believe firmly, definitely it's going to pay you. See, in India you can hire people from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, Assam to Gujarat. In Dubai we hire all this plus 200 nationalities. So people from all walks of life work for us, and at one point of time we had almost 35 nationalities working for us. when any Indian come and work for us in Dubai, especially the young kids, and if he is a Hindu, I counsel him personally and I tell him that, see, in Par Dubai there is a mandir, every Friday there is a aarti over there, please bring a prasad from me, for me, and on Saturday morning with your hand I will take that prasad. The reason for doing this is that in Dubai, among 100 roads, 99 going in wrong direction, one going in right direction. And from person coming from India and especially from the interiors, they are like a spring. You press the spring and leave it and they will bounce. So suddenly, you know, they see so many things. And here, nobody to control. Kona baapno da rahi hai, koi jo aalu nahi. So that element of that mentality comes into them. So I always tell them that please bring one for me. If he is a Christian, I tell them that there is a Trinity Church in Par Dubai. Please bring the blessings of the priest, what he gives. And I have studied in Xavier's. I have taken many patasas from by the hands of the priest and the father, you know, we used to study under him. The Muslim, of course, you know, prayers are there, Friday prayers, and every day be adhere to it. Any person who adheres to his religion will never be a bad person. It is my observation. So prayers, always prays. When you pray, it's not for God. God is so almighty and is so big that prayers helps us. God is not at mercy of our prayers, and God is not at mercy of our acknowledging that, okay, almighty God, you are this, you are that. He is already that. But by meditation, any form of prayer is a form of meditation, may it be namaz or any other prayer. So you are fully concentrating on it, undivided focus on whatever prayers you are doing. So that is helping us. So prayers always pay, make you more spiritual, and in this becoming a better spiritual person, it always helps in your business mindset of not doing any covert intention, which will come in the later slides, to anyone else. Always try to work smarter. See, there are two ways to do it. One is hard way and one is smart way. So always try to work smart rather than working hard. Of course, that whatever efforts required into it, you know, that can be done. See, everything has been compressed in a time machine by time. Earlier we used to send mail. Let's say a mail going to US may take 5, 7, 10 days earlier in the normal post. Then came courier, okay, in 4 days, right? Now email, at a press of a button he gets. So that working smarter is very important, and have to see that in this what particular act, what we do, how we can work smartly. Because one thing what God has given equality, inequality to everyone, that is time. Mukesh Ambani also has 24 hours in a day, and any normal person has a 24 hours in a day. It's how you give productive efforts to your working hour, that counts. Of course, in comprising things, one thing I will tell you, it's not a humorous way, but it's a fact of life which no one can compress it. It's almighty method of delivering a child. That's still a 9 months. So you cannot expedite that. So that, and that is for a reason that you can develop patience in you. If almighty God wanted, he could have given a child on the next day of the marriage. Was it difficult for him? No. It wasn't at all difficult for him. But you know, this is what we develop patience in getting things. Of course, second is, you know, of course, whatever efforts we do, we have to check our seeds are quality seeds. It's very well said in English, you reap what you sow. Jeva bij boso eva phal malse. So in anything you do, especially in the business, whatever efforts done in any activity has to be quality. even if a person or a client wastes your 1 hour and doesn't take anything, he may turn back to be a, turned out to be a good client later on. So you have to do justice to it. And I have a, one example which I can share with you. I joined my father's business in 1990 after doing my college in HL. I was a beginner in the company, and the first thing I was given was a sweeper, to clean my own desk or my work area. And I am so fortunate that, you know, I have learned from the grassroots. And even when I was studying here in college, I had a very clear instruction from my father not to loiter around in the free time. And I was discussing with one of the delegate before the session that Syntex water tank was just introduced that time, BVM. My uncle was one of the dealer that time, and I used to do marketing for that when I was in college. So that has helped me. So this, when I started in 91, there was a Iraq invasion in Kuwait, and that was a big instability in the Middle East happened. After the liberation of Kuwait, one person came to our office, our store, and he asked for only one item, which was costing very less. And he took 1 hour from me, and as I was a fresher, I was explaining him in the way I was knowing that time. That gentleman turned out to be the purchasing director of Kremenko, which is Kuwait Oil Refinery Maintenance Company. In 3 months, he bought around $5 million material from us. And that was the only thing he said, that I went in 2-3 places, and they were not even bothered to, you know, talk to me in detail what you talk to me. So always the quality seeds are very important in whatever you do. Again, you know, there is a very thin line between intelligence and insanity. So we have to make sure that we are in the line of intelligent, but we don't go to insanity. I normally say that, you know, hoshiyar manas ni ek khami hoish. There is a big defect of an intelligent person. The intelligent person thinks everyone else to be stupid. Abhiya badhane bevakuf samjhe. We should not be that intelligent. We have to be intelligent in what we do, of course, keeping in interest of both, keeping win-win situation. And this mindset will help in business, can take you leaps and bounds. We have seen so many companies and so many leaders of that company with covert intention. They have, the company went bust. Along with that, so many families suffered. One of the example is Enron. All the top management and the top executives, they used to siphon huge amount of money, and in the name of bonuses and in the name of other things, and eventually company went bust. Same is with Kingfisher. So to be intelligent is good, but you should not go to that level of insanity where we think everyone is fools. Again, you know, here there is a difference between intelligence and cunningness. You have to be intelligent but not cunning. Very good example in this is that anything you do, if you create a win-win situation, you are intelligent. The moment you try to imbalance in your way, of course, that act of cunningness will get included in that. And our experience says that, of course, the all the connoisseurs sitting here has a much better experience over here. Some of them, their experience must be more than my age also. So anything imbalance does not long last. Any contract in the world, because I have studied contract and we do weighted of the contract also. Any contract in the world which is imbalanced will not sustain. May it be husband and wife, may it be brothers, may it be father and son, may it be any contract, may it be friends. In the world which is imbalanced, even the cars, four wheels are not aligned and balanced, you will not gather momentum, that momentum what you desire. it will start wobbling. So always try to be intelligent but not cunning. In any act what we do in business, we have to have that mindset that are we creating a win-win situation for both the parties involved in that. If that, then of course, you know, that mindset will take you leaps and bounds. Always be humble in whatever act you do. As I told you earlier, as the person goes up, his humbleness and humanity has to increase. That will take you much, much higher place in the society, in the business. If we talk about the humbleness, I cannot see any better example than Mahatma Gandhiji. He was one of the two persons in the last millennium were recognized as a self-actualization. Most of them, they stop on the self-esteem. In the pyramid, as you go climb high, everybody stops at the self-esteem level. But two of them reach to the self-actualization. That is Mahatma Gandhi and Einstein. What is in this self-actualization is, when you detach everything from you, what is your worth? I am right now known because I am driving a BM or a Merc, and people know me because of MD of this company or this or that, with my social this thing and that thing. So my value is attached to something. If that is not there, will my value be the same? ? And that is very well seen, of course, very obvious in the politics, that you know, the moment the person is off the position, then you know how the respect of the subjects are there, you know. So, but if you are humble, if you are kind with the person you meet, they will be same with you all the time. And one thing, you know, a person has to always think when going up, is he going to meet the same people while going down. So that thing has to be always kept in mind. This sense of being humbleness will always prove to be a better businessman, better mindset, and improve your rationalizing power. Expand horizontally. There's two school of thoughts, but I'll just go to this in the current very volatile market. Every big company looks for diversification. Tata, who is manufacturing the most complex engineering like Range Rover cars, they also process salt. Even some of the industry giants who have recognized they got the recognition from one particular product or industry, always looks for diversification into something else. The reason is that it is always good to have $1 from 100 people than to have $100 from one person. So in this volatile market, if four of the products are not doing good, still 95 are giving you yield. So this mindset of horizontally expanding has to be there as a businessman, in their business mindset. Okay, to grow your business in leaps and bounds into one particular field is good, but then always look for alternates wherein you can, once created your brand, you can put it on any label, any product. Can it sell? Do it. In many of the MNCs we see into multi products, they are results of this thought process of horizontally expanding. Now there is always, you have to turn your sales in accordance to the wind. If I am seeing everyone going opposite me, then I have to see that, you know, am I in the wrong direction? If I turn my sales in accordance to the wind, I can achieve that mileage faster. Now, turning your sales, look at the trend, look what is happening, look what are the requirements of this generation, of this, of the market, of the market sentiments. Do business in that product or their mindset, definitely, you know, it's going to yield more results. We have a factory in US, in California, we manufacture vehicle tracking system. It's in 2 hours north to Los Angeles. GPS tracking, yes. It works on three platforms, GPS, GPRS, GSM. It's about 70-year-old company we acquired in 2008. It's not fully acquired, we just took 40% stake in that. So in that company, that product we from Ahmedabad, we do pan-India operations in that. So there is a different punchline on selling these products in different states. Gujarat is, we are blessed with security and a very low crime rate. So this product in Gujarat, we sell on operational improvement, efficiency. The sahib lagavati apna paisa bahu bachche. Bajuma vesadin cha pain pachi ke okay bolo hove. Kanke anything sounding on saving money, we Gujaratis love to listen. Okay, if I go to Bihar, in Bihar we don't sell on saving money, we sell on security. Sir, this will help you in securing this. Because they are spending millions of rupees in securing themselves. Exactly. Turn your sales in accordance to your wind is, position your product well. If I have to sell Mercedes, surely I will not go to Kalupur Tower and do my branding. Or if I have to sell Nano, if I go to the MD of a multinational and explain him all the benefits of Nano, still he's not going to buy. Okay, just for a Photoshop, he may buy one. Photo shoot, he may buy one. But, you know, it's not going to use. So, you know, turn your sales in accordance to your wind is identify your target market, identify where you pitch, and this can take you faster into the business achievements. A very important thing is you have to be the best citizen of the country you live in. And as of course in my appearance say we belong to the Bohra community, and one of the primary preaching of our high priest Sayyidina Mufaddal Saifuddin, may God give him long life, he says that and our Bohras are, you can find them from Japan to LA, like Gujaratis, you know, every country you find a Gujarati there. Bohras are also, you can find them in most of the countries of the world. Be the best citizen of the country you are dwelling. That is very, very important. Adhere to the law of the land. By doing this, of course, you know, that again, you know, that previous slide, what I showed you, no to shortcut, and things will come into this. And I'm just sharing one accolade which I received a few years back. I received an award on Outstanding National Citizen. And thank you. And we all try to be the best citizen of the place where we live in. So that is very, very important mindset. But no, in India I got. Because we do CSR in two fronts, in water and education. A member of World Water Council, but we do small things, and maybe somewhere it was recorded and I was given this accolade, but still I don't think I deserve this. I've yet to work hard to achieve that, and I persistently work on keeping that name alive. So be a good citizen. So by being a good citizen, law-abiding citizen, that sense of violation will not come in the mind. So that's a very important, and a sense of violation will not come into the mind, that will improve the taxpayers in the country as well. So of course I'm not telling, you know, that right now we are not going into the subject of paying tax or evading tax is what are the consequences and this thing, but the law of the land says, and we have to do it. That's where, you know, we have to be. If in any act, once you have that mentality of never for money, then you know your growth will be on accelerated pace. Of course, money is a requirement of to survive. Normally, I say even in money is a byproduct. It's not a source. If I do something, I will get this. Or to get this, I have to do this much. I cannot say I will do this much and I get this much money. So money is always a byproduct of what we are doing. And if you have an attitude of never for money, then you can create a win-win situation. You can always be confident, not cunning. That line between confidence and overconfidence and all these things will come into us, will inculcate into us if we work not only for money. I'll say, of course, money is every commodity in the world is convertible into money. And I say, as I've done criminology also from UK, where Scotland Yard and MI6 is trained, money is the worst invention human has ever made. But it is the best instrument to test a person. So, you know, it can be utilized to test a person. But of course, in any act what you do, it is not, the mindset should not be only for money. Money is surely going to come, one way or the other way. Does anyone defy to this, what I say, that sometimes if we get something, apne kahiye ke kya punya karya ase ke mane maryu? Does everyone believe in this?
Yes.
Everyone believes in this. So think that, you know, if we didn't got here, we are going to get somewhere else. It's definitely going to come. And Almighty God is so graceful that, you know, in his mechanism of reward and penalty, reward he gives in multiples and penalty he takes in one unit. So this is the graceness of Almighty. So money is not a source, it is a byproduct. So when you work anything in business, always think on a product, on a deal, how I can satisfy, am I satisfying? Of course, if it goes beyond some unreasonable bargains are done, you can decline it. But still, the money should not be the focus of that this thing. Any dealings what you do has to be ethical dealing. Now, ethical is a very subjective word. What is ethical here may not be ethical there. But again, it comes to the law of the land. What is ethical here, one has to adhere to it. Like in the product what you are dealing, and our neighbors are very, very smart. Our north neighbors are very smart and intelligent in doing every unethical thing. Anything they produce, they can write made in Germany, they made in USA, anything, the China can write it and give it to us. So that is misdeclaration of origin. I am an Indian citizen, if I travel on a British passport, I can be indicted for that. Same as doing some unethical thing in the business as a misdeclaration of origin. Ethical dealing also says that whatever numbers you describe on the box has to be inside. Of course, we don't, when you buy a box of nail, it's written 1 gross, 144 pieces or 100. Nobody counts that. But next time you count, it will not be more than 90. So, if you are buying from a very fair shop, you will be lucky to get 100. So ethical dealing is something, you know, which has to be there, that a person buys with you with confidence. See, ethical dealing is like sowing the seeds. The fruits may yield later, but definitely, you know, that can make you a brand. Some of the shops, you know, we say, "Ahiyadi kharid jo, bahu saru apesh." That word of mouth. See, Gandhiji said in his book of customers, the one good customer can bring one customer. But one dissatisfied customer can break your 20 customers. So always in business mindset, we have to make sure that we have ethical dealings in the products what we deal in. we are living in the world of ever challenging world. Don't compete with each other, challenge your own self. Like Usain Bolt, how many knows Usain Bolt? Wow, everyone knows. He is a sprinter. He broke his world record thrice. His own record, he broke it thrice. So instead of, you know, challenging someone else, the best person to challenge is the one standing in front of you in mirror. Arisama je samya ubhajan hai, ene challenge karo. So that will help to improve your own self. What I was doing yesterday, am I doing something better today? Or what am I doing now? Can I improve tomorrow? For that improvement, there can be many factors, many help. One of the help is the magnificent complex where we are standing right now, AMA. AMA has been persistently working more than 50, 60 years now. So 60 years, of course, you know, 60 years improving the skill set of the people, in turn improving their livelihood or making them a better person in whatever they are dealing in. So whatever help to be taken, take, but always challenge your own self rather than challenging somebody else. In challenging somebody else, that self of selfishness comes, that self of irsha comes in that. But challenging your own self, you will never get that sense of jealousy in you, because nobody hates their own self. So, and you will always love to improve your own self. What in business, whatever dealings you do, think long term and think on building a brand. See, brands are not built overnight. There is a process of branding which I have given in some of the institutes on branding. Maybe, you know, given opportunity, we can deliver one in AMA as well later on sometime. It is an evolution of five processes. First is, you have to deliver quality. Second, you need to have consistency. Today I build quality, tomorrow something else again. Aaj saru banyu, kale barabar na banyu, paachu saru banyu. I know some of the places, you know, which are famous as joint of tea stall or bhajia or something which they make quality since years and they are same. So this is, first you have to deliver quality, consistency. By doing this, you will get recognition. That aa jagya saru mare chhe, this place you get good thing. This is a recognition we get. Now you need to have a consistency in recognition, then you will build reputation. Reputation is something which goes beyond your boundary. There are certain famous things of India which are famous in other town, we know it here. That aa jagya ni aa vastu bahu sari chhe. So that you know, that is a reputation they have built. And consistency in reputation becomes a brand. Brand. So I'll tell you a story about Mercedes. A person bought a brand new Benz from the showroom, just drove about 100 kilometers odd, and there was a breakdown in the car. And he was furious that, you know, I just bought it new and the car is stopped and breakdown, complete breakdown in the car. He calls to the showroom that, you know, this is what happened to me. The engineers and the technicians, they came immediately and they realized that they forgot to put fuel into the car. They said, petrol notu, atli, how did it run 100 kilometers? They said, it's on the brand. So that's what the branding is. Brand is a difference between the product value and what you're paying. The product value of an iPhone is not more than $30, $40, $50. But what you are paying is $1,000. So that is the value of the brand you have developed. So always try to create a brand and think for a long term. Always, as you challenge your own self, try to raise the elevate the bar of excellence. when iPhone was introduced, that time it was best phone. And if iPhone 2 wouldn't have been introduced, we would still be using the same. It was good. But they bought in 2, 3, 4 with more improvements. They always kept raising the bar of excellence. If you see in the mode of transportation, when the wheel was not invented, our two legs were good enough to go everywhere. And as we live in India, Chardham, Yatra, we loko, they were going on foot. Now, can anyone imagine that? No. So, after the invention of bullock cart, आम थी पर कहीं नहीं चलव तो नहीं पड़े इट्स बेटर देन केम ट्रेन गो टू वन स्टेशन ड्रॉप्ड एट अनदर स्टेशन इट्स इजीयर देन केम कार यू डोंट इवन हैव टू गो टू स्टेशन इट्स एट योर डोर स्टेप देन केम प्लेन आवर्स द डेज जर्नी इन आवर्स सो ऑलवेज ट्राई टू इम्प्रूव एंड एलिवेट द बार ऑफ एक्सीलेंस इन वॉट एवर यू डू There is a big power in smile. As I told you earlier, smile can take you miles. And smile is something which can improve a situation, even a hostile situation, into a pleasant one. There is one video clip which I got some time back. It was about a minute plus something that a person is traveling in a train and he is viewing something and he starts laughing and only he could see what he is and on what he is laughing but as he laughs louder a person next to him laughs a person next to him and they don't even know on what he is laughing at so you know that power of smile can take you miles and it can improve the environment. Always go with a smiling face. This is one of the greatest business attitude a person can have as a business mindset is always be charming and smiling. In our company, if we feel that you know this person has a bad day today or something happened in the morning and which is going to reflect in the work, we tell him please take a day off and come tomorrow. Because that way is going to carry on in every activity what he does. A smiling person, Ghalib has said a very good share in that. Unke aa jaane se jo muh pe aa jaati hai ronak, wo samajhte hai ki bimar ka haal achha hai. If you go to see somebody in the hospital or some ill person, and as you enter in and if they smile, you can realize that he is okay now. You can feel that okay, he is okay now. उनके आ जाने से जो मुंह पे आ जाती है रौनक वो समझते हैं कि बीमार का हाल अच्छा है सो यू नो दैट स्माइल सेज अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स देयर इज वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द वोकैबुलरी वी हैव टू रिमूव इज आई माय मी माय सेल्फ दिस आर वेरी ओके इनफैक्ट यू नो आई अप्लाई व्हेन वी I correspond to anyone, I always write we. When we write, you know, to anyone that we are coming, they are many times question me how many. Then I say I am alone. So but you know, by writing, by removing this I, my, me, myself, you think broadly about we, ourselves and us. That improves the participation, that improves the collectivity in the efforts what we are doing. Always, you know, try to remove this from the mindset as I, my, me, myself. Use only when it is very, very necessary. Of course, if I go into the loo, I cannot say we. So that is that very few instances where can be applicable, but in business, we have observed that giving respect to others, including themselves into the conversation always pays off better. In any business mindset, you know, you need to have a skill development program. As a champion of the industry or, you know, you are a leader of the industry, you have a lot of team working under you. always try to see how your the skills can be improved of your teammates, of your subordinate. In our company in Ahmedabad, we are, every month we receive mail from AMA of all the programs happening in the month. Training is mandatory in our company. Everyone has to go for training. Sometimes we suggest, sometimes they identify, but everyone has to go. Even I attended a training some time back, which was, you know, anger management. So I cannot say I am a PhD and I have done double doctorate, this is too small for me. Nothing is small for us. And in any program I go, I sit like a kindergarten student, because that helps me to absorb what has been delivered. That increases my appetite for learning, and I keep my bowl like this, so the water will enter. The same bowl I will do like this, water will drop and the droplet will go out. So skill development is a very essential thing in the mindset in business. We cannot be that kind of MBA that mane badu avade chan. We should not be that kind of MBA. Improve your skills. Challenge your own self. So this business mindset will always help you to improve your business. Always strive for knowledge, because knowledge is one thing which can help you distinguish between right and wrong. In fact, in Quran it is written that knowledge, ilm, zulmat ko mita deta hai. Yani with light, the darkness goes. With knowledge, ignorance goes. So knowledge, always strive for knowledge. If you are knowledgeable, so you have a better power of rationalizing things. If put into a situation, you can rationalize it better than a person who is less knowledgeable than you. Of course, knowledge also, there is a big difference between studying and learning. I can mug up the entire book and I can speak like a parrot, but how much learning I got from it? That's very important. So the knowledge has to be, you know, every knowledge you acquire, you have to have a good learning from it. The best thing is that you have to apply that knowledge. Knowledge is the only thing in the world which does not diminish its value when distributed. That's the only thing in the world. If I distribute anything, it will diminish its value. 1 rupee distributed among 10 paisas. But if knowledge distributed among 10, the person distributing that knowledge never dissipates, never reduces the value of that knowledge. So always strive for knowledge. In business, always it will help you to rationalize things, identify new things. And all what has been discussed earlier, knowledge will help you to do it. We should have a never give up attitude. That's what an ant, what you can see, you know, it's carrying. Can anyone say how much an ant can carry?
Ten times more?
Any other?
Ten times.
Okay. One research says that some of the big ants, what has been found, they carry 5,000 times more than their own weight. That means if they are 1 gram, they can carry 5 kilo. So that is an attitude we have. A never give up attitude, what we have seen from the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, persistently he propagated against British rule, and never give up attitude, adhering to non-violence, gave us freedom. So there are many, many examples of this. Of course, in the business, this never give up attitude has to be there, but you have to timely always see that is your ladder lean to the right wall. Tame dhaba par chadi gaya ne khabar padi kya to padosi nu jo. You always, you know, make sure that your ladder is lean to the right wall. Otherwise, after reaching the top, you realize that you are on the wrong peak. That has to be always counseled And then, you know, once we know we are on the right way, let's say if you are going in the direction of Delhi and expect Bombay to come, it will never come. But if you are on the way to Delhi, sooner or later you will reach. So, never give up attitude has to be there, but with a counseling and a soul search, are we on the right direction? In a business mindset, everything what we do has to be centric to the customer. Customer comes first. Here, you know, it's not like a chicken and egg which came first. It's now the entire world has identified the strength of the customer. That's why the entire world is aiming to India to sell their products. That's why, you know, such development in so many brands and products and verticals what we have seen in India is because we have huge amount of customers. It's not only 1.3 million, 3 billion mouth to feed. We have 1.3 billion brains to work and 1.3 million customers to serve. So this customer comes first, and India is a classic example right now that everybody is aiming to work with India just because we have that strength of buying and we have that strength of the middle class who are the buyers. So everything what we do, we have to keep customer in the center. Customer has to be focus, every focus has to be on the customer, and then you work on things keeping all the principles back in mind. Definitely, you know, this mindset can take you leaps and bounds. Always be lavish in appreciation. That is one thing, you know, what we cannot be miser in. I'll tell you about our company. We appreciate the person. Let's say somebody if has done something good, we appreciate him there and there. There and there means in a very short time. Otherwise, what happens that if we say, okay, annual function mein aapko samman denge, we are humans. During this time, if he makes a mistake, then that accolade is gone. So we be lavish in your appreciation. A pat on the back or a smile or a word of appreciation doesn't cost, but definitely, you know, it improves the self-confidence of the other person. So always be lavish in appreciation. Even for your child, you know, he does something good, appreciate it. Even subordinate does something good, appreciate it. Many companies, they have a mindset, अरे यार subordinate को appreciate करेंगे वो चढ़ जाएगा सर पे चढ़ जाएगा. It's not going to be like that. Always work in and see that how your subordinate can come to your position. If you are working in that direction, your promotion is inevitable. So your promotion is inevitable. That thing cannot be undermined. Many a times a person always thinks that, you know, should not appreciate or not let the subordinate grow. That is very harmful mindset in business, and that's why we see a lot of retrenches happening in the company, a lot of resignation. Many a time person leaves the company not because of the salary. I know a person who was working for, and I will not name the company, he was in the core group of one of the large conglomerate. He left that position and started his own business. You know, I asked him, why you left this? He said, sorry, the environment was not good. So it is not always for money a person works for. So be lavish. Pardon? Very true. It is said that, you know, murti ko sikke ki keemat nahi pata chali. So, you know, it is something, and always radiate happiness. Happiness is viral. As I told you in the previous one, that, you know, a person laughing, you know, another person laughs, another person laughs. So, you know, it is radiating. So when you radiate happiness, you know, you act as a magnet, and good people will always come to you. People will come to you for many things, and in business, they will definitely choose you against your competitor. So radiating happiness is something which is very important. you know, apne kahe ke some people sometimes what happens in that in a company when you go in, the customers or the clients they are always attracted to one salesperson. That's because the way he is behaving to the client, the way he is radiating his body language, is radiating his vocal language, his happiness to the client. Would you like to deal with a person who is sitting with a sorrow and a deep sense of a illness? Nobody likes to deal with them. So once you radiate happiness, people are drawn to you. And when, of course, you know, we still don't have everything on net purchase or on e-commerce. For many things, we have to have a personal interaction. So in this personal interaction, when you radiate happiness, with this mindset, business will definitely improve. Always try to build a good team. In company, let's say I'll give you example of our company. I always say that I'm the least important person in the company. Who is more important is all apart from me. So I am the least important person in the company. Company can run without me, but I cannot run without my team. The building a good team is very, very essential in the business mindset. When we see our palm, we see five fingers. Are all five same? No. So do you think God made mistake? He gave two eyes same, two ears same, two hands same, two legs same. Why five fingers are different? Because all five fingers have different jobs to do. And all five fingers when put together is a fist. So power is in the fist, not in the finger. Building a good team is very, very essential in the business. You cannot say that I can do everything and I am doing everything. Of course, you know, when you build a team, you cannot find your 100% clone. You are, every person sitting in this room are unique. I cannot find a second person like you, sir, or second person like you, sir. So, but building a good team, we can do leaps and bounds. There are many definitions written on team building, but the one which I like most, I'll share with you. A good team is, in good team, we all are ordinary people, but with a good team, we can get extraordinary results from ordinary people. We all are ordinary people, but in a good team, we can get an extraordinary results. So always think of building a good team. In fact, last time when I gave a presentation, it was a dream team, and many of you must have attended, and that was showing different requirements in building a good team that has to be put in place. If not that, then some other metrics, but you have to have a good team. So that is something which is very essentially required. Now, anything you do in the business, think of a legacy, creating a legacy. And here, you know, a business mindset, you know, a presentation is over, and next, you know, we will switch to the business legacy, and I'll come to what is legacy. So whatever action we do in business, we do with such a mindset that we start creating a legacy. I'm very blessed, and I always say that we are based in Dubai since 1958. We are in business in Dubai since 1958. I was not even born in 58. I am reaping the fruits which were sown by my father. The legacy which is created by my father, which is helping me. Now it becomes a very, very important for us to continue this. So now what is a legacy? A business or a reputation which you live by and to leave behind for someone to take it further. So that is legacy. We have received from someone, from our ancestors, from our father and forefathers, and we create an environment or add to it and pass it on to our next generation. That is legacy. And And the meaning of legacy cannot be known better than the Gujarati communities, because we all know the importance of pedi. We all used to say, kya pedi se. Of course, you know, maybe the new generation sitting here may not know about it, but of course, we know that, you know, a pedi. Pedi is called only when it is passed to the third generation. And many a time they say that, you know, this is, we are working for last four generations, five generations into this business. It's a wonderful thing. So this is a legacy, what, you know, we are aiming at. Now, some of the important, some of the good sayings about legacy is, stay focused on legacy, not on currency. Now, as you know, business mindset, we discussed that not for money, and for many, many, many good values, what we discussed, with a good mindset, we have to work on building a legacy and continuing a legacy. So this is, any act what we do has to have in mind of creating a legacy, if not precedented, or inherited a legacy, how we can pass it on to our next generation in a better way. And it is up to us to live to the legacy what we have inherited from our ancestors and passing on to our new generation. When we talk about legacy, now the big question is, how to create a legacy? What should we do that, you know, we create a legacy? There are certain principles. These are one of the set observed and time tested. There may be some other ways to do, but these are one set of principles that, you know, by which, you know, we can do it. Create identity and work on values. Like certain brands are visible from distance. So your identity is created, and identity is created with values. There are certain foundational principles in which you can create a legacy. All what we talked about in the mindset, business mindset, will help to create legacy. Fourth is, you know, third is this business ethics. Every business what we do has to be ethical. That we'll discuss in the later slides. I'll try to sum up very quickly on this. And of course, you know, we have to adhere to the rich culture what we are having, because as everyone knows that, you know, what was a very good and very famous saying of Swami Vivekananda. It was saying back to the Vedas. That was because, you know, if we go deep in our culture, it was so pure. But as the time goes, impurity starts inducing in it. So when we go to the deep into the culture, that will definitely help us in improving our legacy. I will discuss this in a little quicker way, because we are already running short of time. In identity and values, we should always check our moral compass. That what we are doing is good, what we are doing is morally correct, and what a company has to be based on are values. I was invited by Institute of Company Secretary of India on a talk show, and that, you know, company secretary is a very important post in the company which connects with all the departments. Of course, you know, that's a very important post in India, but not abroad in many other countries, but very important over here. Company has to be built on values. What is common in Tata, in salt processing, and in Range Rover? The values. So that thing has to be worked on. Then, you know, we have to think on means. How are we going to, what are the means by which we are going to attain this? Our instrumental values, what are the instrumental values in this? And every soul searching with our moral compass, with our means, and thinking ends in mind, by doing this, where it will lead to. By keeping ends in mind, on doing everything, we will create a legacy. In foundational principles, there are many, many, these are all what I am saying are good practices of the society. But of course, you know, every time in aircraft, the air hostess say, seat ki patti aise bandho. We have traveled 1,000 times, but still we have to listen to that. So, you know, most of us sitting over here are adhering to most of the principles or beyond this also. But, you know, these are the foundational principles: honesty, integrity, promise keeping. Then, you know, everything what we do is to be, we have to be loyal to the place we are working. That will create a sense of being a good person. So when we are into the business, creating a legacy, you know, our next generation is going to be loyal to us if we are loyal to our ancestors. Many a times we have seen that, you know, Raja no chokro, Raja ne marin gadi par avi jai. And if you see the history, his son is going to kill him. So, you know, that happens, and history has reflected in many places. So, you know, there's loyalty, fairness, concern of others, as we have seen, and reputation is very important thing, you know, what we have to work, and moral. So these are all the principles of leadership, excellence, and everything, you know, what we do has to be accountable and transparent. This is also a very important thing, transparency and accountability. If not to anyone else, to your own conscience. Sit some time and talk to your own conscience that, you know, be accountable to your own self, if not someone else. You know, that will improve your own self, and that will help in building a legacy. Now, as in business ethic, what we see is there is no right way to do wrong thing. Can anyone show me a right way to do a wrong thing? No. There is no right way to do a wrong thing. And against that, you know, I will say that there is no bad day to do a good thing also. So, of course, we believe every days are same. Of course, in belief we have sunny is sunny and Surya is Surya. But, you know, to do good thing, our heart does not stop beating on a bad day. Does it do? No, it does. So keep doing good things. And there is no right way to do the wrong things. The same way, in the other sense, there is no wrong way to do the right things. Don't do the right things wrong way. Please do it right. Always do it correct. See, we are living in such a rich cultural society. So, you know, have open communication and trust is very important. Then be decisive and calculated in your risk. As I told you earlier, that, you know, always stop at one point and do check with your, talk with your, are you going on the right path? You know, that is very, take a calculated risk, not putting all your eggs in one basket. By doing that, you know, you gamble many a times, and then that's the end of it. So that does not create a legacy. So many things, like can Kingfisher pass on his legacy to someone, or anybody willing to take that brand name? No one. So he took some uncalculated risk, such covert intention, which led to something which nobody wants to inherit it. This is very important, to be accountable to your peers, because, and especially, you know, we live in a joint family society, and that is the best way. You know, I always say the best society is a society where people live jointly. That is, and I can prove it with many, many facts, you know, not going detailing into it sometime. Other, you know, what are the importance of a joint family? And we know the values of it. So be accountable to your peers, respect for them, and of course, you know, evaluate performance. Make a good practice a daily habit. It's not that, you know, aaj Independence Day che to maro, I become patriot. On 26 January, I become patriot. No, I have to be patriot 365 days a year till the end of my life. So make every good practice your daily habit. Very important thing, how to maintain a legacy. Of course, you know, these are some of the principles. There are many, many other ways to do, and some of the champions sitting in the audience are legacy holder or are already passing legacy to your next generation. Give family a reason to continue. That is very important. As I told you, will anybody be willing to take the brand name of Kingfisher? No. Do something that your family is willing to take to inherit and have a reason to continue. Okay, that business cannot be the same. Nokia started with manufacturing matchstick. Machis ni dabbi banauti thi. Nokia started with that, ending up making a cell phone and a huge technology company, eventually bought by other giant. But the values in every business you do continues. Tata Sons started in 1800, in the 19th century. That values are still continued now. So that is, may it be any business. So this, and this is very important, that you know, a reason to be given to your family to continue. A good management team is very important, because that definitely, you know, when you are talking about legacy, about that is passing on to the next generation. It's like 100-meter dash. I run 100-meter and pass the baton to the next runner. He passes the baton to the third one. He passes to the fourth one. And when the winner is declared, all four are given medal. So right. So in this thing, you know, a good team is very important. In any legacy, succession planning is the key essence of this. In last session, you know, which I gave, I talked about succession planning. Every company, it is not necessary ke set no chokro set ni kursi par besi jase. It is not necessary. When you have to pass a legacy, he can be a stakeholder, but according to his ability, his position has to be determined. Otherwise, what will happen? The legacy will not continue because he does not have that ability. As a stakeholder, he has that stake in the company. He will get the returns of his stake in the company. Like many of the, we see that the directors are getting, the board of directors are getting returns of there, but the management is done by the CEO and the management team. The company is not run by the directors. They are run by the CEO. Director designs the strategy. So succession planning is a key essence and key element in creating and maintaining the ability. Funding the business, succession plan is when you identified your successor. May it be your eldest son, may it be your brother, may it be your youngest son, then groom him. So funding is not only money, your time, efforts, knowledge, transfer is everything into it. So everything has to be passed on. So unless, you know, there is no chip over here which will go in and program is done. Experiences you have to walk through. You cannot get experience by on a software. So experience is something walk through. So that funding of time, efforts, money has to be given in succession to your successor, making him successful and continuing the legacy further. Structuring the business is very important. May it be geographically, may it be product wise. So if you want to continue the legacy, the first thing comes is family first. The family comes first and then comes business. That's a fundament of succession planning and continuing the legacy. In right place and right product has to be soul searched and identified. That's why company goes for diversification. Diversifying into this field, when they see the potential, continuing their name further. Many companies started with textile. They are into something else now. The textile business is gone, but still their name is there. So structuring it in the right place, right product, you know, is this. Consider the role of the stakeholders. As I told you earlier, the stakeholders are the one who is having the return, are owners of the business, but that does not necessarily be the management of that company. So a very clear vision statement has to be designed for the company, that this is where we have to go. In creating a vision statement, the values of the family, values of the culture and the society has to be taken in place, and keeping in mind the vision statement has to be designed. According to the vision statement, the mission has to be created. The mission is to go reach over there. So every right step has to be taken to achieve our vision and mission. Many companies I have seen, you know, a good vision and mission statements are there, gathering dust. You know, it should not be that, you know. We have to inculcate in our culture a good vision and a mission statement, and then has to follow it. That is very, very, very important. And to continue your legacy, you know, turn your assets into lasting legacy. Like, you know, you see Tata Memorial Hospital is an asset converted into a legacy. Everybody for ages to come, they will think of it. Many families are not there, but you know, there something started by them is still continuing. So even that legacy of name is alive today. CSR can be part of it, but of course, you know, the assets converting into the legacy is not only CSR, but you know, building your own brand, help investing in the own brand, investing in the family, investing in whatever is helping continuing the legacy. And your relation, of course, supersedes your business, and leaving your legacy is the best gift you can give. The last and the soul of today's presentation, the only thing you can take with you when you are gone is what you have leave behind. So what I have lived behind is the best thing what I can take with me. And with this, you know, I come to the end of the program. I'm sorry, you know, it went 15 minutes above the given time, but I hope, you know, it was interesting. I did my level best to convey this subject. Thank you. But I still feel that I am a poor substitute to a good orator. So please forgive me if any instances which you dislike into this.
But the content was very good.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Sure, sir.
Can you be slightly elaborate on what is smarter? To be smarter is better than to be harder.
Yes.
Can you slightly be explain with example?
Yeah, you know, the smarter way is like, let's say, you know, if I have to go Bombay and I have an ability to walk, but if I take a train and a bus or a car, that is a smarter way to do. The harder way, I can of course do it by walking also. If I have that luxury of time and if I have that appetite of walk, then I can do it. But the smarter way is how I can by doing smarter way, we condense the activity and utilize that time for the better way. Any other questions, sir? Sure. Sorry.
I will ask again.
Yeah, please, sir.
See, Tata, who have got the best experience for the last 30 years, the best managing company. See, they sold Tata Nano. Yellow they sold, they gave yellow. It's not that sold was white and given yellow and that is why it failed. Still, such a nice product, they said, 1 lakh rupees product they gave, the same thing, still it failed. Because such an experienced person, such a nice executive of an article and vehicle, still did not work. What is the reason you?
Very true, sir, very true. So company is run by people. Our company sari chale je, our company sari nathi chalti. This company runs well, this company does not run well. So it is people who runs the company, and humans are bound to make mistakes. One mistake is tolerable in 100 years.
No, but still, I don't see it as a mistake. That was not a mistake.
Maybe the benchmarking was wrong. As I have also done a study on the Nano, the benchmarking was that it is a poor man's car.
Cheap car.
Yeah, and the similar thing if you see in Volkswagen is also a people's car. In German language, wagon is car and Vox is people. So it's people's car. Maybe, you know, by improving the branding, one day it will run. See, I'll tell you about the story of Suzuki. Which one was that? One model where Amitabh Bachchan was first in the advertisement. because it has a longer leg specs, a little taller car. Not Varsha, it's a smaller hatchback.
Omni.
No, not Omni. 1000. No, it was little bigger than.
Not
Abhishek. I'm talking about Amitabh Bachchan. That. Not dual. Not that. I'm talking little longer back. So it didn't work. Then they started as a family car. That, you know, a South Indian family was shown and they used to sing something and all number of people came out of the car and start selling. So when they, of course, both were with space. Amitabh is a tall guy, if he can sit comfortably, it is also talking about space. And also, large families sitting into the car also talks about space. But that thing didn't work, that family thing worked. So it's sometime, you know, it's branding and that's a minor improvement. Maybe, you know, of course, see, more champions are working in Tata than all sitting put together over here.
The best effort, the best mind, the best way it was put, 1 lakh car, they gave in 1 lakh, still did not work, is hard luck, I mean.
It's something, you know.
And should not have happened, has happened.
Sure. Yes, sorry, you know. Both are same.
Actually, sir,
I'll give your answer. A good salesman can become a businessman. There is a fundamental requirement in businessman. To be a businessman, to enter into any business, there are two fundamental requirements. If a salesman has that, then he can go into the business. For doing any business, I should have either of the two fundamentals thoroughly. Either I should have a thorough domain knowledge of that product or I should have a deep pocket. If I have a thorough knowledge, somebody can invest on me. If I have deep pockets, I can hire expertise. If not, if both, very good. If not, then you should not take a risk of going into business. A good salesman, his performance is linked because that branch is attached to the tree. Aa dali jhaad sathe jodai chhe any value chhe. Dali jhaad sathe jodaya. After it is detached from the tree, can it do what he wants to do? If not, then you know, to continue as a salesperson and grow, take your incentive is better than, you know, jumping into a business and ending up having a disaster.
Yeah, I'm extending this question.
Sure, sir.
I was a salesman, as a frontline salesman, and you know, reached to a general manager level and aspiring to be a CEO. So, and I have a domain expertise in the last 16, 17 years for that particular business. So, I am looking myself to be a big entrepreneur. So, what is your advice for me to what I look for? Because I have noted down all your most 37 points in detail, actually. I was just looking at you and just watching. I am completely absorbing you, whatever you were talking in the last 1.5 years. Half hours, and I recorded that also, just to getting into more.
Identify what two principles what I told you. If you have thorough knowledge on a product, on a domain knowledge, if you have, prepare a business plan and go to the investor. You know, in Google, after how many investment pitch he got fund? Can anyone say? In Google, after how many investment pitch he got the investment? 33. If you are thorough on your expertise, somebody will invest on you. Prepare a good business plan, because investor sees three things: safety of investment, return on investment, and exit plan. If these three questions are broadly answered, then he will listen to your further talk. But prepare a thorough business plan, because investor is a very matured person. Everything he looks from, see, we talk about, last time I talked about this, we have a 720 degree dimension thinking, 360 like this and 360 like this. So it's a 720, we don't think 360, we think 720. So in 720 dimension thinking, every word what you are pitching, he is interpreting. He finds strength in you, definitely he will invest.
Yeah, and I'm working on it actually. I've given the projections to the board and this is what I'm passing to right
now. No, maybe I wish you all the best.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
You have referred about the spirituality aspect. I look spirituality something like standing on the 10th floor and you can see the whole city. And a person who is on the ground floor is the materialistic plane. And spirituality is nothing else but in the management jargons, the SWOT analysis which we look for. And SWOT analysis, the most difficult job for self, it is very easy to be done for the others or for the organization. Now how to do that SWOT analysis for self? Because the moment you start writing about yourself, the pen stops.
Very true. That's why I said, sir, you have to challenge the person standing in front of you in the mirror. You challenge your own self, that is the biggest challenge. You know, if I am given task to identify defects in any gentleman, I can write hundreds of this. But I am asked to identify for me, my pen stops, if what you say correctly. But that's where, you know, you have to improve the other senses to then, you know, recognize your own self.
I would like to share with you.
Sir, we can do it. We can share this thing after we finish, because we are already half an hour late. I will definitely, you know, we will have a very detailed discussion with you on this. Sir, sorry, I'll take you after this. Yes.
Sir, are there any websites or portals who can take our project for the investment purpose?
Sure. There is a Startup India, Stand Up India. You can definitely, you know, if you have a project ready or a business plan ready, definitely these are the platforms where you can pitch in and you will find an investor. I'll take last two questions, this gentleman and this. Yes, sir.
He is one of the best lecturers we have heard.
No, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. In fact, you know, sir, I see a lot of elders in the room and I seek your blessings. And I told you a little earlier also that I am a poor substitute to a good presenter.
What is that?
We are having five verticals. And as we started business in Dubai, started as a building material company, then we diversified into energy conservation, real estate development. 2008, we acquired factory in US, manufacturing, vehicle tracking. In 2008, we started office in India also. In 2014, we are manufacturing herbal cosmetics with loan license in one factory in Kashipur. And 2017, in Vibrant Gujarat, we made a tie-up with an American company for large this data the management, big data management. So this is, you know, our short journey.
Sir, I have another question.
Can we take it after this? You know, I have to ask this. Okay. We all believe in one thing, which is called relations, blood relations and all. You know, for how many generations is blood relation is continued? Seven? Right? We all believe in seven generations, we can continue business also. If done in a right way, if done with a honest ethics and advice and everything. And that seven can pass it on to next seven. And that seven can pass it on to next seven. I have a commitment of 21. Yes, sir. See, you know, that is a question of succession planning. I'll tell you. Your question is, I'll tell you in a very nutshell, because you know we are already late on this thing. That we call them as a pillow whisperer. Wife on the pillow sleeping at night telling tamare kai thi jase to amaru shu. From that everything germinates. If something happens to you, what shall we do? So they are pillow whisperers. So in succession planning we are having a consultancy wing. In that we do in RTS Global. It's a British firm led by Mr. Raj. He's our founder and managing director of that. I am global partner in that. We do succession planning for large size family run businesses. So the most disturbed area we make them occupy in some productive activity. So you know that idle mind is devil's workshop. So you know we make their mind busy. Sir, last question. I'll take this.
Sir, product diversification strategy achhi rahegi business ke liye ya fir brand same product or brand diversification.
Product diversification we can do once we have spreaded our wings. Now we have reserve fund to put on risk. What we are doing so far is we are championing that. Now we are diversifying. So diversification is only done when we have spreaded our hands. When we have reserves to do R&D, to research, to lot of things. Because it may succeed and may not. Because eventually we all are believer of that fortune is given by Almighty.
Actually, sir, I have read the basic things about the company, that you have to use water conservation, GPS technology, as you said. Sir, so many things, so how you manage and coordinate
those? We learned about good team. So make a good team and you can do it better than me. With this, you know, we come to the end of this program today. If any questions further, of course, I am available here. For some time, we can definitely talk on it. Thank you, sir.
I will request our committee member, Giriraj Bhai, to hand over a memento to Dr. Mustafa. Wonderful talk, sir.
No, sir. Thank you, sir. It's our honor.
Thank you, sir. Thank
you, sir. This moment, this...
In my last 30-40 years, who has combined spirituality, God and business.
Thank you.
Everybody talks only on business, and nobody talks on spirituality with religion.
Collection of minds.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
I will treasure this memento. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Sure. Thank you, sir.